This is the stepper extender for the Ramps 1.4. I'm going to point out a couple of landmarks on it for you so you can understand it better. Over here we have the female pin for, it says 9 volts, but we can use 12 on it, it appears. Then we also have the ground pin. Then we have the ground pin for the board, being the Ramps 1.4. Then we have our 5 volt pin. Over here we have our enable pin, our direction pin, and our step pin. Then we have our micro step switches over here. They're all set to enable, so you can do either 16 or 32 increment of a step. And then we have our port over here for our stepper motor, being a NEMA 17. Then we have our board connections here for our female pins, and that'll enable us to connect our stepper driver board over here. Now, in order to connect the stepper driver board, we have to know where the enable pin is. And as you can see, over here on our stepper extender board, we have our enable pin right here. So in order to find it on the stepper driver board, we need to flip it over and look rather closely. So I'll zoom in here a little so you can see. And what we have is our enable right here. So this is our pin. So in order to connect it, we flip it over and insert it. And that's how we set up the stepper board with the driver board. Next, I'll show you how to actually connect to the ramps. Okay, in order to connect this to the stepper extender, we need to know our pins, so we're going to use auxiliary 2. So here's the ground pin, here's the 5 volt pin, here is the pin 63 or digital pin, then we have pin 59, pin 40, pin 64, pin 42, pin 44, pin 65, and pin 66. Then I'll point out one other thing that's probably kind of outside the frame. Here's our auxiliary 12 volts power supply. There are two pins. The one that I have the actual dental pick on is the positive pin, and the one over is actually the negative pin for it. So in a moment, I'll show you how to connect it. Okay, I'm going to do this in stages, so I'm going to show you the first couple pins first. First, we're going to do the power supply for the auxiliary 12, so we're going to connect it right here. Then we're going to take the positive and put it into the auxiliary 12 on the board. Next, we're going to do the negative pin. This is also known as the ground pin. So we're going to connect the male side over here and the female side to the auxiliary 12 ground or negative pin. Next, we're going to connect the power for the board. So we're going to connect first the ground pin in the center, and then the ground pin on auxiliary 2, which is the top pin in this case. Now we're going to connect the 5 volt pin, and that is the pin just below the negative pin or ground. Next, we're going to connect a couple of things. These are for our stepper drivers. So first we're going to do the enable pin. which is the outside pin closest to us right here. And we're going to connect this to D63, or digital pin 63, which is the next pin over from the ground on the top. Then we're going to connect the direction pin, which is the D on this board, and we're going to connect that on the ramps to pin 40, which is the next pin over. And then finally, we're going to connect the step pin, which is the very furthest over in this example. And that's going to connect on auxiliary 2 to the pin 42, or digital pin 42. Okay, and in the next step, what I'm going to do is show you in the Marlin firmware how to set it up. Okay, in the Marlin folder 1.1.8, we're going to open up Marlin. We're going to search on pins for the ramps, and it says pins underscore ramps dot h. So we're going to open that up. Down below, we're going to search at the very bottom here, because these are our steppers. So as you can see, we have X, Y, Z, E0, E1. Those are the two steppers for the extrusion right here. So we need to add a third one. So what we're going to do is copy the E1, paste it. Then we're going to change the E1 to an E2 in each of these. Now keep in mind, we don't use CS, which stands for chip select. So we're going to comment out all references to that in the steppers. Okay. Now we have to modify these pins for E2 to match the ones that we set up. And so if you were taking notes or you're paying close attention, for the enable pin, which was the very first pin that I connected, it was digital pin 63. The direction pin was digital pin 40. And then the step pin was digital pin 42. So now that we have that all set, we're going to click save, and we're going to close that out. Then we're going to go search on marlin.ino, open that up. Okay, within the Marlin folder, we're going to click on configuration.h. We're going to scroll down to where it says extruders. And we're going to change extruders from 1 to 3. Then down below, we're going to uncomment define single nozzle. We're going to click save. I'm going to connect my USB cable to the ramps board. And then we're going to check to see that we have the right board configuration, which we do, and that COM6 is selected. So now we're going to compile and upload. And in the next portion of the video, I'll show you in Printerface how to set it up. But first, I'll show you how to connect the power like we normally would. Okay, before we get everything rolling here, first thing we need to do is take the cable for the actual NEMA stepper and connect it. So that's now connected. Now we need to connect the power supply power before we put power on it. So we just slide that in. And then we take the power from the power supply and connect it to the wall. Okay, in a moment, I'm going to open up Pronerface and show you how to make the stepper driver actually drive the motor. Okay, now that we're in the Pronerface folder, we're going to open up Pronerface. We're going to connect to the actual printer. And in here, I have to show you something really quick because I've already done it. But under options, I've set my stepper count to 3. If you don't have it set, you're going to have to set it to 3, then press OK. Then close your application and reopen it, and you'll have the option to actually select multiple stepper drivers, being 0, 1, and 2, which is 1, 2, and 3. So we're using actually the number 2, which is our third stepper. We have to actually say for a command M302S0, which says set the temperature to 0. Then we want to extrude. So in a moment, I'm going to show you what it actually looks like. So when I press extrude, what you'll see is the motor turn, hopefully. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.